In this video, I'm going to show you how to create PCB boards in different shapes. For the first example, we'll design a simple LED bulb board that uses 9 LEDs. In the schematic, I've connected 9 LEDs in series and annotated them. I've also assigned footprints to all the components. Now, let's switch to the PCB editor. Here, click on Update PCB from Schematic. This will import all the footprints from the schematic into the PCB editor. To design the shape of the board, first select the edge cuts layer. From the drawing tools, choose the Draw Circles tool. Now, draw a circle according to your requirements. If you check it in the 3D view, you'll see the circular PCB shape. For our bulb board, we also need a hole in the center so that the wire can pass through. To do this, just draw a smaller circle in the center. Again, check it in 3D view, and now you'll see the hole. We want the 9 LEDs arranged evenly in a circle. To do this, we'll use a plugin. Go back to the KiCad main page. Click on Plugin and Content Manager. Now search for Place Footprints Plugin. Click Install. Then click on Apply Pending Changes to finish installing. Back in the PCB editor, select your first component. Go to the top menu, click on Tools. Now under External Plugins, click on Place Footprints. Now a window will open. Select the option Reference Number. This will automatically select all the components. If you don't want to include certain components, hold down Control and click on a component to deselect it. To reselect, hold Control and click again. Under Arrangement, choose Circular. Set the radius to your desired value. Leave the other settings at default. Once done, click OK. Now move the arranged components into the circular board shape you created earlier. I also added two mounting holes to the board. Finally, check everything in 3D view. Here's the finished result. In this section, I'll show you how to create different types of PCB edges. First, change the layer to Edge Cuts. Select the Draw Rectangle tool. Draw a rectangle or square-shaped board. Now, switch to the Select tool and make sure the Edge Cuts layer is selected. Right-click on the edge of the board. From the menu, click on Shape Modification. Choose Fillet Lines. Set the radius to your desired value and click OK. Finally, open the 3D view to check your rounded corner board. Again, right-click on the edge of your board. Go to Shape Modification. This time, select Chamfer Lines. Set the chamfer setback to your desired value and click OK. Open the 3D view to see the chamfered edge board. Right-click on the edge of the board. Go to Shape Modification. Select Dogbone Corners. Set the arc radius to your desired value and click OK. Open the 3D view to check how the dogbone corners look. In this section, I'll show you how to design similar shape board. First, change the layer to Edge Cuts. Select the Draw Circle tool. Draw a circle according to your design requirements. Next, select the Draw Rectangle tool. Draw a rectangle as shown in the video. Make sure the rectangle's corners touch the circle at both ends. This gives us our reference shape. Now, select the Draw Arc tool. Draw the arc starting from the center point of the reference circle. While drawing, make sure the arc starts where the circle and rectangle meet. End the arc at the other point where the circle and rectangle meet. Once the arc is complete, delete the reference circle and rectangle. Select the Draw Line tool. Draw a line from the end of the arc to the length you need. Continue drawing lines until the entire board shape is complete. Finally, click on 3D view to see how your board looks. In this tutorial, I'll show you how to design a PCB board similar to the image. First, change the layer to Edge Cuts. Next, select the Draw Polygon tool. Start drawing the board shape according to the reference image. When you finish, make sure both ends are connected properly to close the shape. Click on 3D view to see how your board looks. Select the design and right-click on it. From the menu, go to Shape Modification. Now, click on Fillet Lines. This step helps reduce complications during fabrication. So here is the 3D view of the board. And that's it for this tutorial. If you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment. I'll be happy to help. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more tutorials.